It's morning. It's breakfast time. It's unlikely I'd get my first cup of coffee anywhere other than a great local diner. Better yet, one I've never been to before.
Coming yours will be right out.
It's just a diner with family atmosphere. When you walk in here, we call you family. When you don't leave being a stranger here.
Kim Goddard is Exhibit A when it comes to friendly people here. She's also the owner. Betty's Kitchen has been a Northampton, New Hampshire fixture for over 50 years, 30 of which, incredibly, have seen Goddard greeting her regulars here.
They've said, "I remember you when you were just a little kid."
You were just a little kid when you started working here, right?
I was 12. My mom got me a job. She literally dropped me off out front. And I said, "Are we going to breakfast?" And she goes, "No, I got you a job. You're going to work for the horse you want."
She got the horse. The diner came only after years of busing and waitressing here. Today, Mom works here too and makes a mean meatloaf. Clearly, the family feeling extends all around here.
They're like adopted parents to me when they started coming in 11 and a half years ago.
But face it, it's good food, not just family, that keeps people coming back and back. Like our new friend, a retired cop here.
You ever do one of these things I noticed they just dropped off over here?
Yes, I have. But being type 2 diabetic, that's a very rare treat that I have one of those.
That would be the calorically cataclysmic stuffed French toast.
I have to try it.
Betty's Kitchen's fans are fanatical and far-flung. As for the owner's biggest fan and husband, well, actually, that took a different appliance.
The toaster had broken down, and I was calling companies. And you know what? He came down, he fixed the toaster.
So you came in to fix the toaster, and essentially, Rush, you never left.
Yeah. Never left, and stuck here ever since. Like the regulars. Yeah.
Yeah.
Did I mention breakfast all day? As a place full of visual inspiration, it's no surprise the New Hampshire Seacoast region has long attracted artists.
Well, I'm inspired by anything that's ocean mostly and drawn to it for all of its effects, whether it's the sound, the smell.
Catherine Rains, who grew up in Scituate, Mass., is today one of Portsmouth's most notable painters, working in the city's historic and restored Button Factory Studios.
You moved to New Hampshire, you tried living away from the coast, and it didn't take.
It didn't take, yeah. So 2 short years later, we moved to a place in Rye.
But like many from out of state, Rains wasn't so familiar with that whole seacoast thing.
I was exactly that person. I didn't even know that New Hampshire had a coast a long time ago.
Today, that coast accounts for most of Rain's work, the simple, local icons of the sea, as she puts it. On this day, Rains was working on a new piece called Mother and Daughter, which follows her earlier, Father and Son.
2 t-shirts. Everyone had asked me, what about Mother and Daughter? So I'm excited to work on it finally.
Bookend pieces.
Yes, exactly.
For those merely viewing and not painting, that coastline beckons also. Thanks to Route 1A, which hugs the shoreline, one of New England's most scenic stretches of road is enjoyed on 2 feet, 4 wheels, or my favorite, 2 wheels.
It's one of the few spots on the eastern seaboard you can ride right along the sea. Just a very beautiful ride.
Thanks to Jeff and Leslie Latimer, owners of Gus's Bike Shop in Northampton, New Hampshire, I had great tour guides and a bike with which to sample some prime seacoast riding.
And this is one of the busiest cycling roads in the state. I think what's so great about it is you can come here to the seacoast and put together a long ride or a long loop, or just a short loop up and stop. You know, you got ice cream spots like the Beach Plum. So really a great opportunity for any type of cyclist.
For the past 10 years, Leslie Latimer has led Gus's Gals, a popular weekly women's ride.
So the first season, it was myself and a couple of my friends, and it just grew organically. And we're not talking about racing here, we're just talking about getting out and going for a ride.
Riders on 1A may also notice signs reading ECG and wonder. I did.
ECG is the East Coast Greenway. The vision for the East Coast Greenway is to have a protected trail for walking and biking that extends 3,000 miles from Calais, Maine, up in the Canadian border, all the way down to Key West.
Audacious, yes. Pipe dream, no. Especially since nearly 33% of the proposed trail is already complete. While much of the ECG will involve new inland off-road trails away from the coast, other sections will take advantage of existing on-road routes like the seacoast stretch of Route 1A. Who'd want to give up these views?
We may be the only state that has none of our off-road route completed, but has all of our on-road route signed.
And for some off-the-beaten path, detouring off of 1A only a block opens up other great rides, mixing cycles and seashore.
I mean, it's just beautiful inside these little towns, you know, here, Hampton, Northampton, Rye. It's a great resource in our backyard for sure.